Hello and welcome to Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Smriti Rastogi. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who addressed the grand Howdy Modi event in Houston on Sunday, described data as the new oil and the new gold. He also indicated that India was in a strong position to lead the world in the Industry 4.0 revolution that relies on big data analytics and digital technology to improve manufacturing. Making a strong pitch to potential investors in America, the Prime Minister also referred to the cheap cost of mobile data in India and referred to the increasing use of digital technology to set up businesses, facilitate economic transactions, and interact with the government. Many people have drawn parallels between what data can do in the present age to what oil and petroleum did in the previous decades. Data is nothing but plain fact. When it is processed and organized in context, it becomes useful as information. This in turn helps policymakers and others to achieve different objectives. Today in In-Depth, we will talk about Prime Minister Narendra Modi's emphasis on data during his address in Houston. We will try to understand what data is, India's Industry 4.0 and the Digital India programs, and the advantage that India has in offering mobile data at the cheapest rate in the world. A new India built on a strong foundation of data and digital technology. That's what Prime Minister Narendra Modi envisaged in his address at the recent Howdy Modi event in Houston. Data in India can drive growth, spur Industrial Revolution 4.0 and bring governance closer to those governed. A study by a UK-based price comparison website shows that mobile data rates are the lowest in India. Indians pay 18 rupees per GB of data against a global average of 600 rupees per GB. In our first report, let's take a look at the Prime Minister's vision for a digitally driven Indian economy.
When Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed a 50,000-plus crowd at the Howdy Modi event in Houston on Sunday, he spoke about the new India that is being built by his government. During the speech, as he emphasized the various schemes and how Digital India was changing the way India functions, he said something very important, that data was the new oil and the new gold. The Prime Minister also said that India was in a strong position to lead the world in the Industry 4.0 revolution, which relies on big data analytics and digital technology to augment and improve manufacturing.
आजकल कहा जाता है डेटा is the new oil. मैं इसमें यह भी जोड़ूंगा कि डेटा इज द न्यू गोल्ड. अगर पूरी दुनिया में सबसे कम कीमत पर डेटा कहीं उपलब्ध है तो वो देश है भारत. आज भारत में 1 GB डेटा की कीमत है सिर्फ 25 to 30 सेंट के आसपास. ये सस्ता डेटा भारत में डिजिटल इंडिया की एक नई पहचान बन रहा है. सस्ते डेटा ने भारत में गवर्नेंस को रीडिफाइन भी किया है. आज भारत में सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट और स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स की करीब करीब 10,000 सर्विसेज ऑनलाइन उपलब्ध है.
Talking about the spread of digitization across the country, the Prime Minister highlighted this year's tax return filing process.
एक समय था जब नई कंपनी के रजिस्ट्रेशन में दो दो तीन तीन हफ्ते लग जाते थे, अब 24 घंटे में नई कंपनी रजिस्टर हो जाती है। एक समय था जब टैक्स रिटर्न भरना बहुत बड़ा सिरदर्द होता था, टैक्स रिफंड आने में महीनों लग जाते थे। अब जो बदलाव आया है वो सुनेंगे तो आप चौंक जाएंगे। इस बार 31 अगस्त को एक दिन में, मैं सिर्फ एक दिन की बात कर रहा हूं, एक दिन में करीब 50 लाख यानी 5 मिलियन लोगों ने अपना इनकम टैक्स रिटर्न ऑनलाइन भरा है। यानी सिर्फ एक दिन में ही 50 लाख रिटर्न, यानी ह्यूस्टन की कुल पॉपुलेशन के भी डबल से ज्यादा। और दूसरी सबसे बड़ी बात, जो टैक्स रिफंड महीनों में आता था वो अब हफ्ते 10 दिन में सीधे बैंक में ट्रांसफर हो जाता है।
The Prime Minister's comments come even as several American digital companies have expressed concerns over local laws that say data generated in India must be stored in the country. India has asked foreign companies to store data locally. This includes personal, social, or financial data that is collected by search engines, financial platforms, or social media sites. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
The term data has been around for some time now. It is said to be the driving force behind many ongoing waves of digital transformation, including artificial intelligence, data science, and the Internet of Things. But what exactly is data and how is it changing our world? Let us find out.
Data is often described as the black gold and even oil of the 21st century. But what exactly is data? And more precisely, big data that is driving economies. Data is nothing but a plain fact. Processed and organized in a context, it is made useful and it becomes information that helps economists, policymakers, managers to decide objectives, design tasks, recruit the talent to complete them, and define strategies.
What, you know, oil has done to the economy globally is what data is going to do. Now, oil, you cannot live without oil, basically. So, what perhaps the Prime Minister Narendra Modi was saying at Houston the other day was data is not only new oil, but it's new gold. In this sense, what he means is we are going to be increasingly dependent upon data for running our economies globally. What does it mean? Means that every piece of data that is there of every person globally is actually stored somewhere, because most of us go onto the internet.
In talking about data, experts give the example of artificial intelligence or AI. In this day and age, AI is at the forefront of innovation. It is powering smartphones, devices of various kinds and technologies. But it is data that helps artificial intelligence evolve, become smarter and come up with new responses. In other words, it is the intelligence in the AI.
These services, digitized services, or e-commerce runs basically on the data that is collected globally. And this data is going to drive your economy, drive your security systems, drive your life completely. So what is happening today globally is there is a big fight as to who will control data. What does it mean? See, most of the data is stored in servers in United States or maybe Hong Kong, with whom they have back-to-back agreements. Now, countries like China and India are seriously worried that this data need not be passed on to international players in an unfettered way, because they think that the developing countries need to have a big say on who will control data, where it is stored, how it is used, and things like that.
It is data about people and their interests that Google and Facebook use to target ads to specific audiences. With more data at their disposal, companies gain more insights about what customers look like, what they want. But while new data makes enterprises smarter, they also disrupt business for enterprises that are unable to analyze it with the right tools. Reports state that while all organizations are increasing spending on big data, quite a lot are on the verge of folding up for not being able to analyze it correctly.
Whenever you visit Facebook, you're leaving your imprint on the site about some of the personalized information that you're seeking. The websites you visit, the kind of data you download, the kind of information you're seeking, all relates to, this is basically personalized service that these companies are trying to provide for most of the buyers. They seek every person as a buyer of their service. So these services, digitized services, or e-commerce runs basically on the data that is collected globally. And this data is going to drive your economy, drive your security systems, drive your life completely.
Unlike fossil fuels, to which it is often compared, data isn't necessarily spent once used. Its value can continue growing as new information is added. But all this needs multidisciplinary expertise to extract, refine, and manage. And only when that is done, actionable business intelligence becomes big data or the new black gold. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha Television.
Large data-hungry base of smartphone users and a fierce price war between the country's telcos has made India home to the cheapest mobile data prices. Data, on the other hand, in US and UK is the costliest. 1 gigabyte of data costs $0.26 in India, compared to $6.66 in the UK. Airtel, BSNL and Vodafone Idea have 2G, 3G and 4G data packages, while Jio has only 4G data plans. The US has one of the most expensive rates, with an average cost of $12.37 for the same amount of data. After India, the mobile data price in Kyrgyzstan is $0.27, Kazakhstan $0.49, Ukraine $0.51, and Rwanda $0.56. Completed the top five countries offering the cheapest data packs. The cheapest mobile data in Western Europe was found in Finland, with an average price of $1.16 for 1 gigabyte of data. Denmark, Monaco and Italy all offer packages below $2. 15 countries in Western Europe have cheaper prices than the UK. In Eastern Europe, Poland is the cheapest at $1.32 per GB, followed by Romania $1.89 and Slovenia $2.21. At the Other end of the scale, Zimbabwe is the most expensive country in which to buy mobile data, with an average cost of 1 GB coming around $75.20. The global average came in at $8.53 for 1 GB. Asian nations make up half of the top 20 cheapest countries, with only Taiwan, China and South Korea charging more than the global average. Israel is the cheapest country in the Near East region, with 1 GB costing an average of $0.90. Human beings are now living in an era that is nothing like the world has ever seen before. In the era of technology, emerging technologies are radically changing our world with each passing day. While previous industrial revolutions made mass production possible and brought digital capabilities to billions of people, the fourth industrial revolution is bringing new technologies that are merging physical, digital and biological worlds, impacting all disciplines, economies and industries.
Industry for 4.0 ka to sara focus hi data par hai. अगर पूरी दुनिया में, जरा गौर से सुनिए, अगर पूरी दुनिया में सबसे कम कीमत पर डेटा कहीं उपलब्ध है तो वो देश है भारत.
At the Howdy Modi mega event in Houston, Prime Minister Narendra Modi said India is in a strong position to lead the world in the Industry 4.0 revolution that relies on data analytics. In fact, India has already taken the next step in shaping the future of emerging technology policy. Last October, it launched the Center for the Fourth Industrial Revolution in Maharashtra. The center, opened by the World Economic Forum, is collaborating with Niti Aayog to co-design new policy frameworks for emerging technology. It aims to bring together industry leaders and the government together to pilot emerging technology policies. Speaking at the launch of the center on the occasion, Prime Minister Modi allayed fears that technology will drive out jobs from the market and will instead change the nature of jobs and create new opportunities.
Bharat. चौथी औद्योगिक क्रांति के लाभ से वंचित नहीं रहेगा, बल्कि मैं मानता हूं कि चौथी औद्योगिक क्रांति में भारत का योगदान पूरे विश्व को चौंकाने वाला होगा. अभूतपूर्व, अप्रत्याशित, अकल्पनीय योगदान भारत का होगा. हमारी विविधता, हमारी डेमोग्राफिक पोटेंशियल, फास्ट ग्रोइंग मार्केट साइज और डिजिटल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर भारत को रिसर्च और इम्प्लीमेंटेशन का ग्लोबल हब बनाने की क्षमता रखता है. मानव जीवन की जिन जिन वास्तविकताओं को हमने आज तक छुआ तक नहीं है, उसके द्वार अब इंडस्ट्री 4.0 द्वारा खुलने वाले हैं. ये नेचर ऑफ जॉब को काफी हद तक बदलेगा, नए अवसर पैदा करेगा.
Industry 4.0 refers to a new phase in the industrial revolution that focuses heavily on interconnectivity, automation, machine learning and real-time data. Also referred to as smart manufacturing, Industry 4.0 combines physical production and operations with smart digital technology to create more holistic and better connected ecosystems for companies that focus on manufacturing and supply chain management. The building blocks of Industry 4.0 comprise 9 technology trends that include big data and analytics, robotics, simulation, horizontal and vertical system integration, cybersecurity, Internet of Things, the cloud, augmented reality, and additive manufacturing like 3D printing. This manufacturing revolution is expected to raise productivity, shift economics, foster industrial growth, and modify the profile of the workforce.
The Digital India campaign was started years ago. And we are already talking where the Niti Aayog has discussed a couple of years back on the need to promote automation. Just this year, CBSE came out with artificial intelligence as part of its syllabus. So it's an optional subject now in CBSE. So India is becoming one of the leading nations which is recognizing that data is the new gold. And to extract that gold, you need great gold diggers. And these gold diggers will go with their mind. And those minds we are developing at our school level and college levels already. And of course, there are various Indian firms which have switched to large data handling. And across the globe, they are creating business. But of course, much more needs to be done also in the sense of consumer data, in terms of how data can help social sector. And that is something for the government to look at.
The Indian center is fourth in the chain after San Francisco in the United States, Japan's Tokyo, and Beijing in China, and work closely with the three other centers to share findings and accelerate impact. To begin with, the center has selected artificial intelligence, blockchain, and drones as the first three project areas. The first project will focus on expanding access to data to accelerate adoption of artificial intelligence to tackle some of the country's most pressing socio-economic needs, such as education, healthcare, and agriculture. The second will focus on the application of smart contracts to boost productivity and transparency while reducing inefficiency. The Maharashtra government, in collaboration with the Center for the Fourth Industrial Revolution India, will undertake a drone mapping operation in the agriculture sector. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha Television.
Digital innovation is reshaping the way most industries and businesses are functioning today. In recent years, India has charted a unique path to digitization, the impact of which is inclusive, empowering, and transformative. Today, India is amongst the top two countries globally on many dimensions of digital adoption. In this report, let's understand how India is moving towards a digital-first economy.
The era of big data has a huge impact on the digital economy, a collective term for all economic transactions that occur on the internet. Cheap data has led to a tremendous growth of digital platforms in the last 15 years. India has provided leadership and shown promise in the use of digital technologies over the past 10 years. Prime Minister Narendra Modi's launch of Digital India in July 2015 played a pivotal role in this direction. The objective of the program is to connect rural areas with high-speed internet and improve digital literacy. Called the Digital India Program, the initiative has three key vision areas: digital infrastructure as a core utility for every citizen, governance and services on demand, and digital empowerment of citizens.
Well, data is a very, very important tool because it tells us what exactly is the social behavior, what are the characteristics of a population, of a product, of even a season, of weather. And now we're talking about, you know, even in space. For example, the whole India's Chandrayaan 2 mission was based on collecting data on another satellite on Moon. So data helps us identify various parameters. In case of an economy, it can tell you what a particular consumer class is wanting. It could also help you in terms of delivery of better services. For instance, the Indian government and many other, you know, data-driven governments use data to deliver healthcare benefits. They use data to, you know, deliver educational benefits. And data is very, very useful for environment, for predicting what is going to be the weather and how the climate is shifting, which is again a big debate in terms of the economics. So there's a linkage between climate change and economics, which is also very, very connected by the bridge of data.
The government started several projects under the program, including digital locker system that minimalizes usage of paperwork and enables sharing of e-documents across agencies. MyGov.in employed as a platform for citizens engaged in governance through a discuss, do and disseminate approach. Swachh Bharat Mission mobile app to be engaged by people and government organizations to achieve the objective of Swachh Bharat Mission. E-sign framework will enable citizens to digitally sign a document online by means of Aadhaar authentication. The online registration system was launched under the e-hospital application. D2I has agreed to an initiative named Digitize India Platform for large-scale digitization of records to facilitate efficient delivery of services to the citizens. BSNL has commenced large-scale deployment of Wi-Fi hotspots all over the country. In July 2019, the government said that India's digital index has grown tremendously. It added that its initiative has empowered the marginalized and reduced corruption in the delivery of government services to citizens. In 4 years, more than 12,000 rural post office branches have been linked digitally. Common Services Center grew to reach 3.76 lakh. BharatNet has reached 1.29 lakh Gram Panchayat. Aadhaar-based eKYC made it easy to open bank accounts or to get instant mobile SIMs. In March 2019, the total number of digital payment transactions hit 332.34 crore rupees. Electronics manufacturing in India also doubled in the last few years. As part of the Digital India program, the government has already implemented direct benefit transfers, government e-marketplace and many other initiatives. Besides this, there's been a steady rise in the use of internet users in the country in the last few years. Due to increased availability of mobile internet, India has around 300 million daily active users, up from 15 million daily active users in 2011. At the current pace of growth, the total number of internet users in India is expected to be 650 million by 2020. The cloud storage service is now being used by millions of Indians. Also, the government is now aiming to set up 1 lakh digital villages in the next couple of years under the Digital India program. Prime Minister Modi has already laid down the vision to develop India into a $5 trillion economy by 2024. The government is also now looking to leverage the data and believes India to be a data powerhouse. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And that's all we have for you in this edition of In Depth. We will be back same time tomorrow with a focus on some other subject. In case you missed the television broadcast, you can also watch our program online on YouTube, the link for which is given below. Suggestions and feedback about the program are also welcome. Thank you for watching.